Okay, I wanted to show this case that turned out as well as we've ever done here at the Dental Implant Center. The patient presented with failing dentition, but quite a bit of good bone in these areas here. And as you've heard me say in all my other videos, we don't take away bone here at the Dental Implant Center. So we're going to use all of the available bone that we can. And that will help us maintain the bone levels, but just as importantly, the soft tissue levels. Here is that same patient's preoperative photograph. Here's the patient's preoperative smile picture on a close-up view. And I think it's obvious that he's got quite a bit of decay, but I wanted to point out his papilla and how red and swollen they are. As you know from my prior videos, I'm very focused on the inner dental papilla. That's what frames the smile, and we want to maintain those tissues as much as we can. So this is a very interesting case of how these become healthy and how we maintain them throughout treatment. And here is the lips retracted view of the same patient. It just shows a little bit more detail of the diseased tissues and the extent of them. And those are the areas that I want you to focus on throughout this presentation. Here's the X-ray after the first surgery. And you'll notice that we were able to place six implants, but we retained three natural teeth. And of these three natural teeth, none of them are going to stay. They're just serving a short-term purpose of holding the temporary and maintaining the soft tissues that I mentioned earlier. Here is a picture of the temporary that was made for the patient on the day of surgery. And what you'll notice already is that the tissues are improving from a health standpoint, but also that the temporary is putting pressure on those tissues, which will help maintain that architecture that we're so focused on. This is the picture of the wax Tryin. And as you've seen in other videos, the wax Tryin is how we assure for ourselves and the patient and their families that the patient is getting the tooth shape that we all want for the best possible outcome. We fast-forwarded here by several months, so what you don't see here is that all of the teeth are out, additional implants have been placed. And now the patient has worn a fixed temporary for approximately 5 months. Any changes we make from the temporary to the permanent are conveyed to the lab, and then we verify those changes by this wax try-in appointment. And I'd like to take this time to point out that when a patient plans to do their opposite arch in the future, we never allow that arch to dictate what we do while we're restoring the opposite arch. So, meaning, if you look over here, these molars, because they haven't had any teeth touching them for so long, they've come up through a process called super eruption. And that means that they've moved from their original position. So, even if it takes us extracting those teeth, or more conservatively, grinding those teeth down, we're going to make the upper arch perfect and not be married to the lower arch. Whether that happens in a month or a year, we still don't want our upper outcome to be affected by an imperfect lower arch. And here's the picture of the final prosthesis. You'll notice that these actually look like teeth, which is our goal. You'll notice that he doesn't have any pink tissue replicated in zirconium, because we never took any bone away in the beginning. You'll also notice that all of our interfaces are convex, that these areas here are cleansable by the patient. Because we've taken the time to develop these tissues in the temporary and maintaining them in the permanent, this prosthesis should never have to be taken out of the mouth. And that's important, that the patient be able to clean these things on an ongoing basis. Even though this may not be the most appealing picture to you, it's one of my favorites because it shows how we've maintained all that beautiful gingival architecture. And in fact, I would even say that in this patient's case, we've improved it. We've taken it from unhealthy, inflamed, and red to healthy and pink, the way tissue should be. And this provides the frame for the teeth that you're about to see. One more picture of the soft tissues developed over the 6 months of treatment. This makes me extremely happy when I see tissues respond so favorably. You can imagine how life-changing these treatments are for our patients. And the thing I've said for many, many years now is it doesn't just change the patient's life, it changes our lives too, because we're so happy to be able to give patients outcomes like this. And here is the lips retracted final outcome view of this patient's new upper implant bridge. He was pragmatic enough to allow us to add natural character to his teeth. And if you want to go back one slide, you'll also see how beautiful his smile is just in his normal portrait picture. But in this photograph, I'd like you to note that we've maintained that soft tissue architecture that I talked about from the first slide. And that is what gives these treatments such an amazing natural look. And that's always been our goal, but it takes time and energy to get there. The presentation would not be complete unless I showed you the before and afters, and here they are. What I love about this case is that you've heard me talk about look, feel, function, and cleansability. I mentioned that in all of my videos about this type of restoration called an implant bridge. We've been able to check all four of those boxes for this patient. I'd like to thank you for watching the video and look forward to seeing you again on our channel.